How'd you get interested in music?
I started off with poetry, writing poetry.
Mm-hmm.
But...
Like junior high, high school?
Yes.
Okay.
Junior high, high school. And poets, I saw were like looked on as like wimps.
Mm-hmm.
So I did that personally, but then I started turning the poetry into songs.
Mm-hmm.
And that got more attention.
How'd you get into rap?
It is of my opinion that I was rapping while I was writing poetry.
Okay.
And so I was into rap, I guess you could say, from junior high when I wrote my first poem.
Mm-hmm.
And after I heard on the radio that there were other poets who made records and they were selling and it was working, then I decided to change the method of my poetry.
How do you define rap? What constitutes rap?
That's what it is, poetry. To me, it's storytelling, poetry.
So we moved to Baltimore, which was total ignorance town to me. I mean, Baltimore has the highest rate of blacks killing blacks
in the country. When I auditioned for the Baltimore School of Performing Arts, then I started to have good luck times.
You know, parents are the same, no matter time, no place. They don't understand that us kids are going to make some mistakes. So to you other kids all across the land, there's no need to argue. Parents just don't understand.
I spent 3 years in Baltimore, my high school years. I made a lot of friends,
like John Cole and Jada Pinkett.
You should have seen this girl's bodily dimensions. I honked my horn just to get her attention. She said, was that for me? I said, yeah. She said, why? I said, come on and do your ride with a hell of a guy.
I loved my classes.
We were exposed to everything. You know, theater, ballet. Listen to different types of music. Songs that became the soundtrack to my life. But in my homeboys high school, it's not like that. They don't have trips to go see this Broadway play, and they don't read things we were reading, and they didn't know what I was talking about when I was like, yo, Shakespeare's dope. They don't have the same experiences that we had. So then I started thinking, because the art school I went to was mostly for white kids and rich minorities. So I started going, damn, man, I would have been a totally different person had I not been exposed to these things.
I need money. I used to be a stick-up.
Like, at work, I can't hold a job. I just quit my job today, actually, because I wanted to come and do this. And they wouldn't let me. And I felt like it was important, and it was more important than serving pizza. And we had enough people, so I felt like since I'm an actor, they should understand. They should have let me do it, but they didn't. And then I had a cold, so they were making me work in a freezer. And I'm really not one to be disrespected, and I felt like that was disrespectful because I asked to go, you know. So I quit, and he told me I couldn't quit. And that even made me hyper. I'm arrogant. So when he told me I couldn't quit and we had all these customers, I chose that time to jump on a soapbox, grab my leather jacket, light a cigarette in front of him, smoke, and leave in the middle of a rush. So that was natural. That's arrogance at the top. That's what I think I'm most like my mother. And she likes it. She'll see it in me and know it. And we clash a lot because I'm arrogant, she's arrogant. And you should see us when we get in our little attitude moods. It's like husband and wife, or it's brother and sister. But it's father, mother, and it's really father, mother, and son. She's my father and mother. So, yeah, we get in our tips and everything.
Upon my release, I felt like I wanted to be seen as a complete human being. I'm through mimicking characters for people so that they can get a better understanding on what young black males are about.
I want to mimic whole characters so that I can get a better understanding on what men and human beings are about. So now it's like I don't care about making people understand how we are. That's what I used to do. Every part was just about digging deeper into who young black males are, and I felt like I was
a roadie and as a dancer. Mm-hmm. Was that real? When I mean, I just read that you used to like do dance, you know, the dances with the plastic.
Do the dance with the naked doll. That was me. That's what I mean by I'm real. I'm truly hardcore because I needed the money and I had to work. So if you told me that for me to get paid, I had to go out there in bikini briefs and hop on top of this doll, and that's how I got to get paid. And I was homeless at the time. That's what happened.
I went to school all the way and was ready to go to college. The only thing that stopped me was money. The time we all the kids in my school was writing applications to go to college, I didn't have no lights or no electricity. And that ain't my mama's fault. You know what I'm saying? So when I think back to that, I'm not thugging for me, I'm thugging for my family. I pay all the bills. You know what I'm saying? I feed my whole family. Wrong or right, I do. And I can't stop. You know what I'm saying? And if thugging is gonna make me $1 million, because it just got me platinum, then that's what I got to do. You know what I'm saying? If thugging is gonna make me $1 million, because it just got me platinum, then that's what I got to do.